All right, hey y'all, welcome to my channel, or welcome back. So today I'm just gonna be reviewing the TGIN Rose collection that came out. So I have the shampoo, the leave-in conditioner, and the hydrating hair mask. And so we're just gonna start off with my crusty, dusty hair. It was super dry, you guys. So I figured this would be a great time to test out this collection. So I'm just starting off in sections. Of course, this is how I do my wash days all the time. Just spraying my hair with some water, and then I'm going in with my pre-poo, which is actually the African Pride pre-poo. I love this stuff. It makes detangling my hair so much easier. So after I did that, this is what we are looking like, and then I'm gonna go into shampooing. So I'm not gonna show you guys shampooing my hair in the shower because everyone knows how to shampoo, but I will let you know that I always do two sections or four sections, just depending on how great of a wash I need at that point in time. And since I knew my hair was just dry, not necessarily like super dirty as far as my scalp goes, I just went on ahead and did this in two different sections, which I am showing you right here. So just gonna go in with this shampoo, which ended up being pretty nice. I would repurchase it again. And I also spent a good amount of time just rinsing my hair and trying to loosen up all the dirt or whatever is in there prior to shampooing, so I don't use as much shampoo. I don't know, it just helps me. It just makes me feel better doing that. So this is how my hair is looking, you guys. Pretty good. It felt pretty hydrated. It wasn't like super moisturized or hydrated, but it wasn't stripped either, so that was a plus. So this is the hair mask. I wanted to just kind of show you guys some clips just so you'll actually see the product on my type 4 hair. And I do have a low porosity hair. I do need to do like a new strand test or test my porosity again, and also in different areas, because that does make a huge difference. That's kind of more important than your hair texture, is knowing the porosity. And honestly, I just need to learn a little bit more about porosity and the right products to use and so on and so forth. So like I said, or I don't know if I said it actually, I did use heat with this hair mask. So if you do have low porosity hair or type 4, 4B, 4C hair, heat is gonna be your friend. I have a little sit down spiel at the end of this. I'm kind of like repeating everything that I said right now and adding just a little bit more, but I don't do product reviews often, so you guys be kind. I'll get used to it and how I want the video to flow and all that kind of stuff. So just going in with the leave-in conditioner now, you guys, and really trying to concentrate it on my ends. It's giving me some shine here, and I did seal this with the melanin oils. Once I started using a good amount of product on each section, I started to feel my hair feeling a little bit more moisturized, much softer, and a lot more hydrated and all that great stuff. So just stick around. I'll be right back in like 2 seconds with a little spiel, like right now. All right, hey guys, welcome to my channel. Welcome back to my channel. So I have a quick, not really, it's not gonna be quick. I have a review for you guys on the new TGIN Rose Water collection. I purchased this like at the end of April. I didn't see anything on it when I got mine. I didn't see anything announced on their website or on Ulta, because I did buy from Ulta, or anything like that. And I was like, oh, well, maybe it's new, maybe it hasn't done well. I really didn't know what to think, but I just got it anyways. And I just want to say that TGIN is one of my absolute favorite brands for my natural 4B, 4C hair. The honey line from them I absolutely love, and it's perfect for my texture hair. So I'll kind of just be comparing that line to this one. So I only picked up the shampoo, the deep conditioning hair mask, the hydrating hair mask, and the leave-in conditioner. I saw the gel on Ulta, and then I know they have a foam as well, but I don't do a lot of gel styles on my hair. Like, I don't use a lot of gel, so I didn't see a point on getting it. So I just kind of left that out, and I just figured for me, these were the most important products, so I just wanted to try those out. So starting with the shampoo, I like the shampoo. I thought it was pretty decent. It does say it's a moisturizing shampoo. I'll give it that. It's not as hydrating as the shampoo from the honey line. I think what I like the most about this particular shampoo was the fact that it left my hair
very clean, but it did not strip my hair either. I don't really have a hard time finding a decent shampoo, so I would just kind of, I will use this all up. Would I buy it again? I'd probably buy it again, just because to me, a good shampoo for me is not that hard to find. And it didn't strip my hair. It cleansed it very well. Down, did it like super moisturize it, hydrate it, that kind of thing? Not necessarily. But for me, if a shampoo doesn't strip my hair and my hair doesn't come out like super dry and crusty looking, then I consider it a win. It didn't wow me, but I would probably buy it again, if you guys understand what I'm saying. But a lot of shampoos don't really wow me, just because they're definitely an important step. But for me, it's not the most important step. Now, I got really excited about this line because, of course, it was pink. I'm not gonna lie, I was like, oh, that's cute, you know. I did not realize it does say a gentle hydrating deep conditioner for waves, curls, and fine textured hair. Ain't nowhere up in there did it say kinky type 4B, 4C hair. So I was like, oh great, what's gonna happen here? It is very runny. It's not that thick deep conditioner that you would get like from Shea Moisture or anything like that. It's very runny, liquidy, kind of reminds me of a leave-in versus a hair mask. I did end up using quite a bit. Not as much as I thought I was gonna use, but I did have to like really use a lot to coat my strands. And I don't know if I was the biggest fan of that, but it is what it is. As far as how it came out though, like how my hair was soft. It came out soft, manageable. Was it super hydrated, super moisturized, super like butter to my hands? My hands were just going through my, not really. It took a second for it to like soak into my hair. I did find that it just kind of set on top of my hair. So I did use heat with this deep conditioner to help penetrate the conditioner a lot more through my low porosity hair. And I think that helped quite a bit, because when I rinsed this out, my hair felt very soft. It wasn't extremely soft. Again, this whole line for me wasn't like a wow factor, but it was decent. So yeah, so it wasn't extremely soft like the Honey Miracle Mask does. That's one of my all-time favorite deep conditioners, period. If you have not tried the Honey line from TGIN, I highly recommend it. It is absolutely amazing. So would I buy this again? Probably not, because I would rather just get the Honey Miracle line. When I apply it to my strands, it literally melts into my hair and feels like butter. Like it just melts all the way, and I love that conditioner. So I probably will not repurchase this. I think I just used too much in it. It did okay, but it did not wow me. And honestly, if I'm gonna be spending $15 on a deep conditioner or more, it has to wow. So as far as the Rosewater Smoothing Leave-In Conditioner, I liked it. I think I would purchase it again, but I'm not 100% sure. I did again have to use a decent amount. This is how much I've used on my hair, plus my husband just used it on his, and this is how much we've used so far. It's kind of a lot, but I do like the thick consistency of it. I like thick products on my type 4 hair, and he said he liked it on his as well. So he put this in his hair, and then he put the Uncle Funky's Daughter on top of it, the Curly Magic gel, and I think it came out really nice. We didn't do his whole head, but we just kind of tested an area, and his curls was popping, they were shiny, they was glossy. I think that's a really great combination. His curl pattern is looser than mine, so I would probably say his is more of a 4A curl pattern, and these two went very well together. So I did have to use quite a bit of product for this, and the smell is pretty strong, you guys. It has a pretty strong floral scent. So if you don't like scents like that, you may not like this leave-in conditioner. But I did find once I started to apply more of it, and once I applied the right amount of conditioner, I felt a difference in my hair. So that's a thing with me as well, is because I don't mess with my natural hair too much, I typically don't apply enough product whenever I'm doing a certain style. But this time I tried my best to like really coat, you know, each section that I had. and just seal it with a light oil. Would I buy this again? I don't know. I really don't know, you guys. And just to put it out there, I've been having a really hard time finding a really great leave-in conditioner. So if you have any like suggestions or anything like that, I would greatly appreciate it. It was pretty easy to detangle my hair afterwards. So I will say the line is not bad, you guys. Would I say give it a try if you have 4B, 4C hair? Yes, I would definitely say that. Just keep in mind that the products are meant to be lightweight. They're not gonna like weigh your hair down a lot. So which is great, but if you're really looking for, you know, something of a heavier consistency, I don't think this line is gonna be for you. I do see why this line is geared towards finer hair as well, just because heavier products do tend to, you know, weigh finer hair down. So I completely understand that. I'm a little bit confused if this is really geared towards 4B, 4C hair, maybe even, yeah, I would say probably 4A, but mainly 4B, 4C hair. Simply because it doesn't say it one in the deep conditioner for starters. And that's deep conditioners are huge when it comes to 4B, 4C girls. And I didn't see the kinks, curls, waves, you know, like that kind of thing, that little tagline that most people put. So I don't know. I don't really know if it's really geared towards us. I understand you can have fine 4B, 4C hair. I totally get it. But for those of us who don't have finer hair, I'm not 100% sure if it's geared towards us. However, that doesn't mean it can't benefit us as well. So that's pretty much it for this review, you guys. I hope it was helpful. If you have any questions or concerns or anything like that, please put them down below and I hope I can help you out. Until then, thank you guys so much for watching and I'll talk to you in my next video. Bye.